You can taste a little of summertime. Oh, you can taste a little of summer.
Folks, welcome to the Tiny Tent Show. We would all love to be gathered up under canvas. Shoot, we all love to be gathered up just anywhere right about now. What we decided to do is to put up to the internet, as I hold among this group, and try to get a little something live from our own little place. I'm above my garage down in Fall Creek, Wisconsin, and we're going to meet some other folks that are ready to play a little something for you. Before I do that, I just want to say that the board at Lake Superior Big Top Chautauqua has asked me to say regarding the upcoming season that the plan is to continue as booked. Of course, these are not the days of plans. And so what the board will do is let you know that they're watching the situation closely, and they will provide updates as available. The other thing, briefly before we start tonight, Tent Radio is going to do its reference to this, but I just wanted to mention tonight that one of the founding members of the Blue Canvas Orchestra, T. Bruce Bowers, left this world for another just recently, and so his family with Yasmin and Hope, and you know, if we lose our connections here tonight with a vision of T. Bruce drawing magic from his electric violin. So I'm going to go ahead now and introduce a familiar face to any of you who have been up to the Lake Superior Big Top Chautauqua under that beautiful blue and pearl gray canvas. And I'm going to introduce Danielle Diamond. And Danielle, can you hear me?
I can hear you. How are you?
Great. This is like doing the moon landing in the 60s, man.
I know. It's so fun, though. I'm so happy to be.
It's great to see folks. So you were going to do a song for us tonight, and can you let us know what song you're doing and why you chose to do it? And then I'll just get out of your way and let you sing.
Sure. So originally, as we were planning this, I was going to play one of my own songs. But after hearing of the unfortunate passing of the great Bill Withers, I was asked if I would sing Lean on Me tonight. And so I will gladly do that. I hope I do it justice. So rest in peace, Bill. This is Lean on Me.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. But if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Please swallow your pride if there are things you need to borrow, for no one can fill those of your needs that you won't let show. You just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. somebody to lean on. You just call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. So that you have to bear, that you can't carry. I ride up the road and I'll share your load if you just call me. Won't you call me? Won't you call me?
Thank you.
Oh, thanks, Danielle. That was just the thing. Well, I'm going to introduce another musician now, very, very familiar to those of you who've been up to the Big Top. He sits down on the job a lot, based on my experience, but I guess we'll allow it. I'm also really pleased that he took the time to do some set design, and I accused him of leaving up his Christmas tree, but he says it's an Easter tree.
Yeah. You know, I gotta point out that you said that too. I mean, I'm just saying, you know.
Doing it right now, brother.
Yeah, an Easter tree. A lot of people don't know about the tradition of Easter trees. It's traditional that you keep it up since Christmas, from Christmas until Easter, and then you take it down soon after Easter. But if you don't take it down and it passes the 6-month mark, then you have to leave it until next Christmas. So, you know, we'll keep track of that. So, hey, I'm going to play. I'm going to play a couple of short pieces together that if these guys were in the same century, they would have been friends, I think. So we'll just take it from here.
Thank
ain't the same. I'm acting funny, and I don't know why. Excuse me while I kiss the sky.
Everybody.
Yes, Ed, that's I was waiting for him to light it on fire, but I'd hate for him to light that beautiful intro to that Easter tree.
Yeah. This one is not my lighting on fire instrument. I haven't opened that, but
yeah. Well, that was beautiful. Thanks for doing that. I think you covered the musical spectrum. So yes. Couple of things here. One small little bit of business. It never hurts if you swing by www.bigtop.org and find out a little more about the tent and the folks. And especially tonight, they have a link to the Tiny Tent Show, and there are various ways that you can support the folks who work up there. The second thing is I'm going to do what I do on the radio show now, which is a little intermission monologue. It's going to be pretty brief, but I thought for tonight, since, of course, we're all focused on not being able to gather and having to keep our own counsel and company during these times, sometimes folks ask me about the tent, the beautiful blue and gray tent up north there, and they ask me where else, and I actually wrote a little piece about the best seat in the house up there, and I'd like to read it now. I'm going to put on my hipster reading glasses and get after it. The best seat in the Lake Superior Big Top Chautauqua tent is not for sale. I don't say that to be snooty or snotty. I'm just letting you know the way it is. Don't obsess over it, because the seat is located in a section theater professionals refer to as obstructed view. So obstructed, in fact, that you can't even see the show from there. The spot in question is situated in a brace of old drop-down theater chairs set up along the backstage walkway between the stage and the dressing rooms. It's cozy back there and quiet. From this seat, you can see the artists preparing to take the stage. Some are one-namers, so famous they're recognized worldwide by their first name alone. Some should be famous, but are not. And some are making their first stage appearance ever. Actors shuffle to and fro, muttering their lines. Black-clad stagehands hurry through prop or string them. You'll see a musician musician leaning in to bring his guitar in tune, or a vocalist, her throat wrapped in scars, hunched in a chair and cupping a mug of honey lemon tea. Now back and forth, checking and rechecking the dry erase board for curtain times. Veteran performers checking email or discuss health insurance deductibles. The lights are low and everyone is getting ready for the show. I especially cherish this season early in the spring season or in the final weeks before strike, because the crew keeps a pot of good coffee going just off the wings, stage right, and the smell is even better because of the edge in the air. It's enchanting to sit in that theater chair and observe this charmed space where performers take one last deep breath before heading out to the lights and applause. Sometimes they leave behind hints of their preparation, a scribbled set list, a curled and highlighted page of script, a cell phone still glowing with the last number dialed being the number home. Then the show begins. And even from back here, you can feel the electric momentum of it, the way the performer and audience agree to dive in and see what happens. Sitting in the suddenly empty backstage space, you can hear the little things that don't go out over the sounds, the scuff and twist of a dancer's slipper, the thump of a musician's heel keeping time, the creak of the stage as an actor crosses. You can see into the tangle of cords and girders beneath the stage, where an electronic light blinks, relaying some information that means something to someone. And then, and this is the best part of all, through a gap in the velvet skirt at the stage front come distinct sounds from the audience, an anticipatory titter, an appreciative gasp, an overloud clapper, and sometimes, when the performer has drawn a tent full of strangers deep into the center of the moment, the fragile expects silence. I think of that silence up there now, you know, the tent is rolled up and stowed and snow's coming down on that hill. It's all fragile, expectant silence. And I think we're all experiencing a version of that right now, which makes me all happier to say our final performer this evening is going to break that silence for us. The veteran of the Big Top. I think the first time I ever talked to him, it was in the basement of the library up there. And so it's my pleasure to let Tom Mitchell break the silence. How are you doing, Tom?
Hey, Mike. I'm going through a lot of them, trying to get stuff thrown away during this quiet time. And I actually came across the questions I wrote down for the interview that we did in that basement library.
It's amazing. I hope my answers remain consistent over the years. Or maybe not. Maybe I hope they changed. What do you got for us just musically, Tom?
Well, Michael, I'm going to have to ask you for some help because I prepared two pieces. I just couldn't decide which to do. So I prepared two and I'll give you, I'd like you to help me decide which one to do. The first one, is the snare drum part for Ravel's Bolero.
One of my very favorites.
Yeah. It's the whole side. It takes up the whole side of an LP. But I'll play you the part as it's as written, and then you can tell me what you think. And so forth and so on through the entire orchestral piece. Now, the second piece I prepared is just a simple harmonica song that doesn't take much time at all. So, what do you think?
Well, here's what I think. I would love to hear Ravel's Bolero, especially I'd love to hear you do it. But I think that song this evening is filed under the category of a time and a place this ain't the time and this ain't the place. So how about you fire up that harmonica?
All right. you're probably just worried about the copyright. All right. I got a little song for it. Corina, Corina, oh, where you been so long? Corina, Corina, where you been so long? I'm worried about you, baby. Honey, please come home. I got a bird that whistles. I got to burn that thing. I got a bird that whistles. I got a bird that sings. But I ain't got Corina. Life don't mean a thing. Hell, you've been on my mind. Corina, Corina, oh, you've been on my mind. When I'm down thinking of you, I just can't keep from crying.
Thank you, Tom.
Welcome. Thank you.
I'll talk to the management, see if we can book you for that bolero thing at another time.
Okay. I'm ready for it. Okay. I got the part down.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for tuning in, if that's what you call it, in this instance. A big thank you to Danielle Diamond and to Ed Willett. And to Tom Mitchell. Also, you didn't see him, I don't think, unless he really messed up, but there's a guy named Austin Hamilton that's making us all appear together here doing that magic. So thank you to Austin. If you get a chance to swing by bigtop.org, that's the best place to go to support the tent up there and work to keep it standing, literally and figuratively. And also, one more time, we salute T. Bruce Bowers. And then I think I'll just end things the way I usually end and say thanks to everybody. And well, I suppose.
Howdy, folks. From Lake Superior, Big Top, Chautauqua, at the top of Wisconsin, welcome to another episode of Tent Show Radio.
I can't believe another year's gone around. Is that a big top I see there high above the ground? Ballyhoo. Oh, ballyhoo.
Support for Tent Show Radio is provided by Travel Wisconsin. There's a million ways to have fun in Wisconsin and no reason not to. Visit TravelWisconsin.com and plan your trip today.